Now I go to the most important quantity. That important quantity is the two particle distribution functions, which is defined here. So now I want to know that what is the probability if I have one molecule here, another molecule there. In other words, I also want to know later in a homogeneous system how many molecules are there, I have been discussing. So now I go by the following important definitions. The radial distribution function is joint probability of having R1 and R2, one at R1, another R2, and that is divided by rho square, because if this probability is independent of each other, Pn is independent of each other, then Pn R1 R2 would be, it is P2, then R1 R2, then I will have P1 R1, P1 R2, and that I just showed in homogeneous is same. So that become, you know, I just showed in homogeneous system this is nothing but density. So then P R1 R2, if there is no correlation, then will be just by rho square. So it makes sense now to define a quantity where the joint probability distribution, which is Pn R1 R2, is divided by the rho square. Because in the limit, in a homogeneous no correlation, and also in the limit when R1 and R2 are widely separated, then in when R1 and R2 are widely separated, in this notation R is R1 minus R2, R1 minus R2. So Shubhajit, please make these corrections. In a second edition we will fix all these things. So the radial distribution function, now we have a, this GR is the radial distribution function. Again I motivated that it is in a, it is number of molecules and in a shell at a distance R, this gives the GR, and it is a very pivotal quantity in theory of liquids. So now go back, so we have showed this is rho R. Now we want to do two particle distribution, just I motivated it there, that then will be in the from n particle distribution, which is defined here, n factorial n minus n factorial of this quantity, then I get two particle P2 R1 R2. I am little bit uncomfortable with both R1 and R2, because in at the end of the day in homogeneous liquid it is only the distance between them. It is both R1 R2 not needed. It is, I can select my coordinate at 1 and then I can only consider R2 as a distance R. So basically it is a distance, a scalar that becomes, which is far simpler quantity. And the R1 R2, if I keep it as a vector, then it is 6 dimensional. But what really matters in the homogeneous liquid is 1 dimension. So which is a tremendous simplification and something people should be aware of. So just from the last one I get this thing, I integrate over R3, R4, R5 to Rn, and then between then the configuration integral, Mayer's configuration integral, and n factor n minus 2. Now that of course I can now divide, I can start seeing how rho square will come out. I can then this quantity will be rho square, n going to infinity, this quantity will be rho square, and then if they are not interacting, then Zn is V to the power n, and this V square will, another V to the power n minus 2 will come here. So I will get back these conditions then. So this is a very cleverly written by multiplying and dividing by V square. Okay. So the motivation of GR is now clear. Motivation of GR is that thing, is very, is clear, and so in n particle GR is P2 R1 R2 by rho square, but R1 R2 is what we need actually, is R1 minus R2, this quantity. So, this is the radial distribution function, which is the probability of getting two part that there are two particles at separation r. That is the central quantity of our discussion here. Okay. So, we now go generalize to n particle distribution. Many times we need the three particle distribution G3. So, from the the discussions I have done, this is Gn, and then density, then rho r, I give a this delta function representation is kind of a simple but a straightforward thing that we now want to be talking of n particle. This is not quite correct. Rn equal to so I that means that n is missing this delta r minus ri. So they are n particles, and this is a complete distribution of n particles. That means what is saying that it is essentially the Pn, but delta function representation of that. But the quantity is that I can go to Gn n particles. So they are what one is saying that I have n particles in a capital N particle system. I have tagged small n particles, and I want to know what is the probability of this in a huge system. There are many, many molecules which I am not, which I am going to integrate over. But I have, so the green plus red are the total n. So, but my small n is 3. So, I want these 3 particle positions, and the R1, R2 and R3, and that what is the probability of having 3 particles at R1, R2 and R3 when n equal to 3, then I have that description. And I define that as the 3 particle probability distribution, then normalized by rho cube. It is done for inhomogeneous system that I give, otherwise I will just make it Pn r to the power n divided by rho to the power n. That would be this quantity. As I said, delta function means you can say, okay, I can write this thing now as sum over delta r minus ri and I equal to 1 to 3. So, I have the position of these 3, and that is rho, then will be rho 3 r. So, this is the definition of delta function represent. That has an advantage, we will see little later. Okay. So, homogeneous system, this averaging that we are talking is comes out like that is not very important. Okay. So, now however, in a 2 particle distribution it becomes kind of interesting, because then I can now write, if I have 2 particles at R1 and R2, then I can write, okay, one particle at I have to sum over. So, if it is in just constant particles, the same not constant identical particles, then I can say my rho r at R1 and R2 is just integrate over all the other molecules, n number of integration, the idea r to the power n. But before all our definitions, we were making this integration to n minus 2. But now, because of delta function representation, I can put it in and say, okay, one particle at r, another particle is r prime. Actually, if I have to look at that, then that should be R1 and R prime is R2, then this is becomes the then delta R1 minus Ri delta R2 minus Rj, I sum over all I and j, and if I make them a double sum, then I have to take an over counting, I have avoid that, I have to take half, which is half. So, this is rho R1 R2. So, if I can do that now, the number of ways I can pick it up is n into n minus 1 by 2 particles, then this is the same thing as that we have done in the last page also. And same thing again repeated here. So, nothing new we are doing here. So, we have now developed a definition of GR. So, we define GR in terms of e to the power minus beta u r. So, starting from and partition function, we get this quantity and a definition of gr. We have not evaluated gr yet, but we have the structure. Next, what happens? So, now we take a little bit back and say, okay, what do you know about gr? Before you evaluate gr, which is difficult, but has been done with great accuracy in many large number of systems. But there is two ways one can get it directly. One is radial, one is the computer simulation, and there is neutron scattering, and also, as I told you, these days in X-ray in random systems. So, what we are doing essentially are random systems, structure factor of random systems, and liquid is one of them. But of course, the what I am doing is also goes for glasses, that goes for very much glasses, and which is more and materials, surface things like, you know, mobiles, the surface of the mobile, we need great need for the structure of the liquid crystals. So, all those things exactly follows this terminology. That is why the terminology, though we are doing in the context of liquids, this is a terminology and the nomenclature that goes into perfect whole of physics and chemistry. So, the radial distribution function RDF, radial distribution function, same as GR is RTF. So, how do they look? Now, we have plotted here radial distribution function of say around this blue one. This is a little bit silly drawing, that because there is too much of a structure, really not too much of a structure. But what it does, this shown that this is the central one, the red ones are the first layer and the blue ones are the second layer, and actually blue one I should draw some more maybe. Okay. So, now you see near in the first layer, this one, there is a very sharp peak, almost reminds you of a crystal, because liquid has a considerable amount of short range order, all the liquids, water, short range order, it is of the kind of thing we discussed in Ising model, the same short range order. Molecules are placed quite like a crystal in the first layer. So, this is the radial distribution function structure, there is a sharp first peak, but the first structure in the first layer is due to the excluded volume interaction, because the molecules are packed together, they are touching the surface. Then comes the second layer, because the first layer is structure, second layer is also structure. That structure is like you are packing people, see, in a bus, like in places like Calcutta or Bombay, bus are very crowded. So, if you are in a center of a crowded bus, then the people around you will be finite number, and they will be, you will find 4 or 5 people around you. Then if it is the big bus, then another 4, 5 or 10 around the second layer. So, the Hertzsprung interaction or the repel that you cannot penetrate, two molecules cannot penetrate, that it has a volume and size that dictates this arrangement. That is what I meant, that is the Hertzsprung part of the interaction, repulsive part of the interaction that determines the structure of a liquid. This is very, very important to know. The structure of a liquid is determined by this repulsive Hertzsprung interaction. Dynamics also to a great extent by that, but phase transition and many properties is a competition between this repulsive part of the interaction and the attractive part of the interaction. These two together drive the properties of a liquid and a. So, this is what now GR, if I now do this calculation, that just it is exactly what Barnall did in his, he was a genius this way he did. So, if you do that, then this is the Barnall kind of GR that we get. Radial distribution function in a homogeneous system of that gives you how many molecules are placed at what distance. Now, the important thing to know, the structure factor, where do you get the GR? So, how do you get GR? Experimentally, so long I have been talking of partition function, experimentally does not care about your partition function. It can, he wants to measure, and indeed he can directly measure. This was shown first time and done on the first time by Vanoff, a great physicist in around 1950. It is, I think, 47 to 50 around that time. Lady Hood is after Second World War when neutron scattering becomes. He could get the scattering cross section from a liquid, and that gives you the structure factor Sk. And that from then, these are the equations we will briefly derive, but we will not go very detail into that. That the structure factor Sk, which is measured from neutron scattering cross section, is exactly given by the radial distribution function. So, Sk is essentially given by with certain p factor. This is a equation what its weight in gold. So, it is essentially Fourier transform of. So, this is my Gr, this is a Fourier transform. Other factor like 4 pi are here, and so this is the one that I get from neutron scattering. So, from differential cross section, we will describe a little by d by sigma. This is this total scattering cross section differential, because what is the amount that goes into if incoming beam coming, then gets scattered, then what goes into an angle located at sigma, that is the cross section is connected to total number, because exchange of momentum, this k is the difference of momentum between incoming and outgoing, and that is because of the positions, the length scale, and that will show the derivation. But this is, as I told you, it is what it's. This equation V is a golden equation. So, static structure factor Sk by neutron scattering is gives you the radial distribution function directly to an extent. That is the most important take home message of today's lecture, right? Okay. So, now this is now going to do now soon that static, this is the geometry that incident beam comes in, gets scattered. So, the Ki is incident beam, K2 is the scattered. This goes to forward scattering, the representation of neutron scattering. If we can do that, then with the plane wave, the coming neutron is a plane wave go around, that is with ki going out is also a plane wave going k2. Then one can write the wave function, blast total wave function that is going out is a linear combination of the two. But most important part is that is a comes from Fermi golden rule. The scattering cross section is square of the interaction between them, and once you do that, this is the Fermi golden rule, that this is the square of the interaction between the. So, the particle coming, and here is my sample. The neutron interact with my molecules here and get scattered off, and that gas is given by the scattering here, which is nothing but interaction of the neutron at particles at position ri and incoming neutron, and that is r minus ri sum of the delta function, the kind of thing we told before. So, this one now can be transformed into by fairly simple algebra, and using the delta function representations, one can show that the scattering cross section is connected to this k prime is written as k2 minus ki, that we will do just k later. So, this is the structure factor, and one can also show that the structure factor is k is same as rho minus k, that is done in the book, and that is the same as this quantity. And so, static structure factor, which is measured by, forget about this k, by this is experimental quantity, this is experiment, and this relation is the theory, and this Sk is nothing but the radial distribution function as we have. Yeah, this is the equation. So, you know Sk from neutron scattering, and then we can invert this Fourier transform and get the Gr, and Sk is getting from neutron scattering by the following fairly trivial manipulation that this is measured experimentally, that directly gives SK once you know this cap, this parameter BRB. That is we have done now, is known as the static structure factor, and this gives the correlation, and we just show that this gives GR, most important quantity, not just in liquids but in glasses, in materials and everywhere else. That is what the huge number of people are measuring in neutron scatterings. Okay, we are done. So, thermodynamic, one can get the thermodynamic functions from radial distribution functions, and we'll continue that in the next class, little bit of these radial distribution functions. And so today we stop, and we'll take up from here, and then we'll go tomorrow to a very related thing, which is theory of polymers. Okay.